What is good, mga champion, and welcome back to another video. So, weekend ngayon, what better things we can do is simply, of course, on my side, preparation. So, mas gusto ko maging productive during this weekend. So, instead na gumala or mag-party-party, again, on my side, I'd rather be prepared for the next trading week. So, I will walk you through the process on how I look for trades and how I look for opportunities, particularly one of my favorite pair, which is GBP, GPY, or what we known as Pound Yen. Okay? I will be using just the basic TFP war system para panimula. Okay? But nevertheless, if you want more deeper concepts such as market behavior sequence, money trap, and other important aspects para mas maging magaling kayo as a trader, you may want to check my TFP VIP Champion Mentorship course that is designed kung ikaw man ay zero knowledge up to advanced levels. Okay? So again, thank you so much to all my TFP VIP Champion students all over the globe at sa lahat ng mga sumusuporta. Alright? So without further ado, let's get straight to our charts. Alright? So again, currently, we are here in Pound Yen, one of my favorite pair na tinitrade. Okay? Number one, because of its volatility, this pair simply exhibits significant volatility sa market. Nevertheless, okay, anong ibig sabihin nun? It possesses a lot of trading opportunities, mapa long term man or short term. So again, iba-iba tayo ng style, like swing, day trade, or scalp. Again, if you know your system rules, okay, nothing can go wrong. But nevertheless, always take into consideration yung inyong risk management and trading psychology, right? So again, how are we going to analyze tong Pound Yen? And what opportunities ba yung pwedeng ibigay ngayon ng Pound Yen? Okay? So, I am on a daily time frame, so which means I'm seeing the market on a bigger scale. Okay? So, tandaan natin. So, first thing we should do is simply, ano ba yung market structure as of now? Okay? Ano yung market structure? So, if I were to check the past data, so daily ako, let me just check sa weekly or monthly para lang makita ko yung overall picture as a whole. Okay, so sa monthly, okay, hindi ko naman sinabing magpunta kayo lagi sa monthly, but nevertheless, I just want to see the overall picture. So, sa monthly, kung makikita nyo, di ba, market is probably heading towards this area. So, it might have a reaction, but nevertheless, again, that doesn't mean na magsasell tayo agad. Okay? What we can do is simply look for variety of time frames para mas makuha tayo if yung opportunity ba na binibigay ngayon is pang long term ba or short term. So, kaya kailangan aware pa rin kayo nasaan kayo sa mas malaking time frame para hindi kayo nagugulat bakit tumaas, bakit bumaba, di ba? This and that. So, this provides you more clues para aware kayo anong mangyayari sa price. Okay? So again, aware tayo na we are heading towards this level. So, but that doesn't mean that we are going to sell. Okay? Tingnan muna natin if magsasatisfy yun sa ating rules. Okay? Balik tayo sa daily. Okay? So alam na natin market structure. So as a whole, di ba? Although pataas, papunta tayo sa isang peak kung saan pwedeng mag-react yung market pababa. And considering yung market structure na to, so meron tayong uptrend, di ba? So this is a group of a bullish market. So this one group, and kung mapapansin nyo, higher low, and then what happened, diba, ito yung higher high, nagkaroon ng weakness. So ibig sabihin niyan, there is loss of momentum afterwards, but we cannot say the market is downtrend na dahil lang nagkaroon siya ng initial weakness. No, we must break through a certain level, for example itong higher low na to, for us to look for opportunities if talagang selling yun. But nevertheless, dun papasok ang ating key leveling at ano? Key leveling at the same time yung ating consumances such as trend lines. So, again, hanapin muna natin. So, basic, okay, di ba? Guha muna tayo ng trend line. So, that's basic approach. Trend line, okay? And plot our basic support at resistance levels, okay? So, ang ating support level, kung mapansin nyo, is this area, around this area, okay? So, wala naman eksaktong ano yan. But, a good practice, sabi ko nga, is simply, dapat at least covered yung mga ranges na yan. So, normally, iba, ako, ginagawa ko rin naman siya as range. But for me, alam ko naman na nasa support level yung market considering merong mga multiple reactions. So, hindi mo naman kailangan saktuhin yan. Ang idea dyan, alam mo lang kung nasa ang level ka as of now. Okay, that's the idea. Okay? So, tandaan nyo, nasa daily tayo. So, again, if I were to trade now, okay, am I at the high probability trade zone? Okay, am I above support level? Am I above horizontal and trend line support? Do, have I broken, again, have I broken counter trend and resistance? So, mapapansin natin, aware tayo that the current market is sitting dito sa support level provided, alin, provide itong mga multiple reactions. But nevertheless, how can we look for opportunity? So, tandaan natin, on this time frame, we are on a daily, again, the high probability trade setup, simply, kailangan meron tayong mga confluences. So, again, at least two confluences, sabi ko nga, if you are to buy, di ba, kailangan you must be above horizontal support and trendline support. Okay? So, ibig sabihin yan, this can be a good spot para ikaw ay magbumili long term. Okay? Nevertheless, if ikaw naman ay nasa selling area, definitely, you must be below of that key levels. Plus, tandaan nyo, this support level is your higher low from the structure. So, ibig sabihin, pag nabasag yan, okay, that would be significant for the ano, seller. So, meaning, ang sell opportunity mo would be, okay, around this area, considering you are now below break of counter trend support and below nung dating support that will knock in future as ano, resistance kapag ka nabasag yan. Okay, so this would be your selling opportunity for sell. Again, on this time frame. But nevertheless, ang gusto natin is, how can we look for opportunity provided wala pang nasa-satisfy ni rule dito sa ating higher time frame. That's the time na pupunta tayo ng ano, lower time frame. Okay, take note, if we're going to analyze, di ba, nagkaroon na tayo ng weakness dahil hindi siya nagkaroon ng higher high. But, come to think of it, nag-react pa dito yung market, meaning nag-hold pa itong support level. So, again, this is still acting as your higher low. So, potentially, the market can still go up forming a higher high. So, yan yung pwede nating isipin in terms of technicalities na pwedeng gawin ng market. Plus, makita nyo, meron ng presence ng ano, buyers. Okay? So, what we can do is simply look for lower time frame ranges para mas mabasa natin at mag-provide pa ng more clues in terms of structure. So, take note also na itong bearish candle na yan, nabahag nitong bullish candle. So, ibig sabihin, may significance tong high nitong previous bearish candle momentum. Okay? So, we can mark that as a resistance na nabasag nun. So, it can act as what? As a future support. So, again, what we can do now is simply go to our lower time frame para mas makita natin ng mas maganda yung structure. Right? So, punta tayo sa 4 hours. Okay? So, ano nakikita nyo, guys? So, sa 4 hours, kung mapapansin nyo, okay, we can see here na we can connect few confluences tulad ng trend line. Okay? Plus, we're going to analyze, meron tayong nabasag na counter trend line resistance coming from this point of view. Bakit? Diba, itong peak na to is actually your high dun sa ating bearish candle kanina. So, sabi nga, napaka-significant yun kasi in terms of structure, diba, magkaroon ng consolidation, nag-breakout, and then nagko-correct yung market. So, most probably, nagkakaroon ng momentum na bubuelo yung buyers papunta sa taas. Again, we cannot assume, but nevertheless, magko-confirm lang tayo once masatisfy na yung ating mga trading rules at ano conditions. So, again, based sa system rules natin, di ba, if I were to buy, I must be above ng trendline support, okay, horizontal support, at ano, I have broken counter trend line resistance. So, which means, significant tong area na yan. And, what I want is the market saan. Okay, this would be my high probability trade zone as a, ano, as a buy. Okay? So, ibig sabihin, what I want is simply a correction. A strong impulse, most probably, any correction dito, okay, bago ako mag-take ng ano, long position. Okay, so yun yung trade idea natin for this pound yen. But nevertheless, anything can happen sa market, di ba? But we have to be prepared sa yung mga areas na pwedeng pumunta yung ano, yung price. So that's why we plot our high probability zones in advance. Okay, so if ever naman the market broke through dito sa level na to, again, diba? Diyan magmamato yung what? Selling opportunity. So, take note, kapag ito naman ay nabasag, let's say, nag-zigzag yan, and nabasag to, itong trail and support, so meaning your trading opportunity as a sell is around this area, if mag-follow through pa yan, okay, around this area. So, again, we both have long position and short position opportunities. Okay? So, again, bakit tayo pwedeng mag-long ngayon is meron nga tayong nabasag na level, okay? Kahit na merong weakness, nevertheless, this is still considered a long opportunity, pero tandaan nyo, hindi siya long term. Okay, bakit? This will be significant on your target. Bakit? Ito yung higher high. Pag hindi mo yung nabasag, definitely, market can act as a double top, which in return, di ba, pwedeng magkaroon ng bearish momentum. Okay? So, the only time na magte-trade ka lang long term as a buy is nabasag mo itong higher high. So, this higher high and higher low sa overall bigger picture is very significant as a whole. So, ang trading range ko lang would probably as a long position is hanggang dito lang. Okay? Dito sa area na to. Right? Okay? So, my area of opportunity na pwedeng galawan is this level. As long as, ano, pumunta yan dito, sumampa siya dito sa aking horizontal support, will be now above as well nitong trend line support. And of course, since may break of counter trend line na ako, this would be a good spot as I buy papunta saan? TP hanggang dito. Okay? So, ang gagawin nyo is, kung nasa 4 hours kayo, again, you can do a 15-minute execution, but if you are in 1 hour, diba? Let's check. Same logic. Okay? What we want is simply, okay, an area of opportunity kung saan pumunta dito yung market. Okay, kung 1 hour ka, then look for 5-minute entry. I-TP mo lang siya, at least 1 to 3. Or kung medyo conservative ka, use this as a target. Short term lang. Itong gap lang na yan. Instead of the 15-minute na ang trading range mo hanggang dito. So again, that's how flexible dapat yung inyong system. Na kahit anong condition sa market, kaya nyo dapat i-trade. Hindi nalilimitahan as long as you're satisfying rules. Okay, yun naman yung importante. So, ang mangyari dyan, if you're just trading impulsively or based on your gut feeling, then you don't need a system, di ba? Magkakamali ka eventually. So, again, this is just a short tutorial para magbigay sa inyo idea how we used to analyze the market using just basic concept of support resistance, trend lines. So, dapat hindi ito magiging hadlang para hindi ka makakuha ng opportunities. Considering napakadaming pairs, napakadaming pwedeng time frames na pwede nyong i-trade as a range. So, nandyan yung daily, 4 hours, 1 hour. So, in just a single pair, sabi nga, pwede ka makakuha ng multiple opportunities. So, as long as you follow your rules. So, as of now, wala pa akong setup. That's why, today, this is just a preparation stage. Ano yung mga pwede kong gawing opportunity for the next following trading week. Okay? So, I hope this video helps para mas magbigay sa inyo ng ideas how you can analyze the market in variety of ways, mapa-selling or shorting. So, ibig sabihin yan, don't limit yourself as long as yung sistema nyo dapat can trade any conditions ng market. Okay? So, that will be it for today. Thank you so much to all my TFP VIP champions students all over the globe, subscribers, followers, and sa lahat ng sumusuport. Alright? So, God bless all of you. See you all on the next videos. Bye-bye.
So, I just want to inform and announce that our TFP VIP champion student private Discord community is already up. And yeah, here we have several channels wherein we share our technical trading ideas among each other. And of course, we also have our weekly trade ideas para sa ating mga weekly forecast para sa mga currency pairs. And some announcement section. And of course, since tayo ay global. Of course, we have other students as well na galing sa mga ibang bansa overseas. So, we here, we introduce ourselves and introduce kung saan tayo galing, sa bansa tayo ngayon, OFW man o hindi. But nevertheless, this is a healthy community para mag-share ng mga trading ideas para sa inyo guys. And hopefully, I will be putting up a server publicly para sa mga baguhan naman and those mga followers and subscribers natin, alright? So, yeah, this is just a minor announcement and hopefully, guys, you can join us and make this community grow, lalo na sa ating mga estudyante nag-aaral, alright, guys? So, mga baguhan pa lang. But nevertheless, everyone here wants to learn, wants to make profit from the market, but as much as possible, we're all equal in the eyes of the market. Alright guys, so that would be it. So yun lang, and thank you very much. Alright, bye-bye.